Hey, I'm Terry Hitchcock. You're watching Harkins Theaters behind the screen, so it's time to go all Bear Grylls. We are on location here in the Catskills, trying to simulate a little of what Kate Winslet and Idris Elba went through in The Mountain Between Us. And let me just tell you, with a bunch of journalists and some instructors with us, nothing compared to what they had to go through in the film.
Alex,
can you look at me?
You really hurt your leg.
Your phone's smashed.
My phone has no signal, and we're pretty high up on the mountain.
It's a Sunday. Yeah. You're in bed. Yeah. You're reading the book. What was it about the story that you said, I'm going to make this thing?
It's the combination between survival and love. You don't have this together. You know, survival has a different palette of colors, a different structure of story, and love is a complete different feeling, you know? And how you put them together, it's a big challenge. And I love challenge.
I read somewhere, or maybe it was an interview, Kate, where you said, the older I get, I'm more of a wuss. You could have fooled me.
Do you know what? After, I would actually change that now.
Okay, good.
Because after doing this film, I just loved it. I couldn't wait to get in that water. I couldn't wait to get in the helicopters and go up to 10,000 feet. I couldn't wait for all of it. And I loved the challenge of it. And also I had, as a mum, I'm nearly 42 now. My daughter's about to turn 17. You know, there's something incredibly empowering about being that strong to be able to do something like this and to live to tell the tale and to raise my lovely family and sort of be ticking all the boxes. You know, I felt so pumped and amazing after making this film.
Were you this giddy about some of this stuff, or were you like, this is way too cool? I'm not loving this. Like, were you as excited?
Do you know what? I got there. I definitely got there. You know, when I was reading the script, I was like, ah, I could just imagine, oh, this is gonna be tough. This is gonna be a long day. Oh, there's a night shoot. But then, you know, once we got up there, every day we flew in a helicopter. You know, flying in a helicopter is an exhilarating thing, whether you're scared of flying or not, but it's beautiful. And we saw vistas that not many people get to see.
Ice, anyone?
Cold was the cold, but actually because, you know, we were both so immersed in our characters and our stories that was part of it, you know, and I got used to that. I do feel like, Kate, though, coming out of that experience, I feel way tougher than I was before. You know, in London, people talk about the cold. It's like minus one.
Right.
They're like, oh, my God, it's freezing. It was at minus 38. Do you know what I mean? So it's like practically.
And we'd get in the car in the morning, and the first thing I would do is I'd look at the thermometer on the dashboard, and I'd go, oh, it's only minus six. We're fine.
Right.
You know, so minus six was literally like, positively toasty.
It was so cold. Yeah. Like one day I couldn't talk. I couldn't talk. These muscles were frozen, and I closed my eyes. Because tears came from pain. So
right. Were people like, "What's wrong with our director?"
I like his eyes closed and his mouth is shut.
You actually think we're gonna make it?
We're still alive.
We also made our dollies on snowboards, on sleds, and the grips made three versions of it. One that would go fast, one that would go in deep snow, and one which was a low angle. And so in pre-production, we worked out the things that were needed to actually make it work.
Was there ever a day where you're like, all right, whose footprint? That looks like, who left the footprint? No days like that.
No, well, we had to film the rehearsals all the time because of footprints. And then if we did two or three takes and they'd make different footprints, then the post-production would have to paint them out.
There has to be a way down.
No, we just got to go back and find another way.
I think if we follow this path...
We're not doing that. We follow that path and we die.
Who out of the two of you would have been the first to actually leave the wreckage? Because, you know, your attitude is we got to stay till we're found. You need to do something. Who out of the two of you would actually be the first one to leave and say we got to move?
In real life?
Yeah.
I think we both would. Right? Mm. I wouldn't sit still. My character is a neurosurgeon and probably thinking, you know, it's quite... balanced mind, Idris would have been like, we gotta go,
right.
Let's go.
But
let's
me, Kate, I would never have gone alone. I would absolutely never. I just know too much about how unpredictable those environments can be.
But you went with the dog.
I did go with
you
the dog.
You did go with the dog.
That's true, actually. I did go with the
you
dog.
You were smart, yeah.
And that, yeah, I mean, that amazing dog who would have gone back to the plane had something gone wrong.
Yeah.
but our amazing dog who you know, he was a really lovely animal.
His name is Riley.
Oh,
Oh, he did have wonderful. A name, because I know in the movie you really don't, there's not a name yet.
No,
so
no,
yeah,
no.
His name's Riley, and he was really a really special character, and properly a character. Yeah. You know, he was like, hey, I am the best guy to hang out with. Right. You should really hang out with me, because I'm like the most fun.
I follow him on Snapchat.
Sadly, I'll bet he has more followers than I do, so I wouldn't be surprised at all. I may have to start following him,
which would be more followers than me, because I don't even have it, so he's got one up on me.
Yeah, boy. What are you doing?
Can I have the dog?
Oh,
the dog was, come on. The dog was amazing, right?
No, as let's say the results, but he was not the actor, believe me.
He was.
Oh my God, he won't listen.
Well, he's very talented, so I guess he has a little bit of a right to have an attitude.
Yeah, a diva. He was a diva.
I want you to take a picture of me.
Why?
In the movie, there's a great line where you say, can you just sit still? How hard is it for both of you to just sit still? You're so busy, you're so active, you're doing so many things.
This is
you...
the stillest I've sat for weeks. No, it really is.
And I'm jealous. I am so jealous. I haven't stopped since I left you. I'm so jealous. It's hard for me to sit still because I'm always running about.
Come on!
I feel like the moral of the story is always have Idris Elba with you when you go to a precarious place.
He's
such a man in this movie.
I know, absolutely.
Although I actually think your husband could have pulled this off, because I read a lot about him too. I know he's very active and outdoorsy, so
well,
he might have.
He was the guy behind the scenes that was like, had given us advice. I mean,
he was like an extra crew member, actually.
Yeah,
he really was.
He was the man.
Yeah, he was completely amazing. I mean, he came up with all kinds of equipment that even our wardrobe department had never come across. And so he would pack me up to work each day. I'd go with these heated battery-powered gloves and this incredible scarf and all of these wonderful things that, you know, made a huge difference. And Idris ended up buddying up and using my gear, and that was all that was all Ned.
Definitely.
Alex!